Hi friends, here in this video, I'll be explaining cylindrical locator. So, let's get started. Now, here is the diagram of a cylindrical locator. First of all, what is a locator? A locator is an object or a device which is used in the body of a jig or fixture so that the workpiece is mounted over that locator and we get a proper relationship between the jig or fixture and the workpiece in order to perform any kind of machining operation. So here there is a simple cylindrical locator as shown in this diagram. It consists of basically two parts. This bottom portion of the locator is called as the shank, and this is the locator. So what happens here is, compared to the shank, the locator is having a greater diameter. This diameter is greater because we do not want this locator to go inside the jig or fixture body. That is why we have kept this diameter of the locator greater than that of the shank. The shank portion is fitted into the body of the jig or fixture as shown in this diagram over here. That when the shank is fitted over here, here there is a locator and it is having chamfer on the top, and because of the help, with the help of this chamfer, we can easily load or unload the workpiece like it is shown in this diagram. There is a workpiece which is mounted, but here there is one condition, that for such kind of cylindrical locators, the workpiece must be hollow, or we can say there should be a previously drilled hole in the workpiece so that we can locate it in relationship with the jig or fixture. And at the same time, we can also say that the cylindrical locator, it will be used only for one particular kind of workpiece. Like once this locator diameter is fixed, it would be used only for one single diameter. We cannot mount the workpieces of different internal diameters over here. So that is one of the disadvantages of the cylindrical locator, and to overcome that we have conical locators. So basically this diagram of cylindrical locator, as we see, it is just used to locate the workpiece so that we get a relationship between the workpiece and the jig or fixture body, and it is properly aligned. At the same time, there would be some amount of rotation about the axis. This is the axis of the locator. So the workpiece may try to tilt or it may try to rotate about the axis of the workpiece. So in order to avoid this rotation, we need to constrain the workpiece. So in short, that was the video regarding the cylindrical locator. At the end, if you all find my videos helpful, you all can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.